There are several different options for backup storage redundancy in Azure SQL. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Uros, who is a program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks, Anna. Happy to be here today.
Happy to have you. And today we're going to be talking about understanding backup storage redundancy in Azure SQL. So before we get into it, I just wanted to kind of ask you if you could give us a brief backup overview and explain why these are important.
Of course. So backups are an essential part of any business continuity and disaster recovery strategy because they protect your data from deletion or corruption. And in Azure SQL, customers can use two types of backups for restoring their databases, short-term backups and long-term backups. Short-term backups are the backups that can be configured for up to 35 days and can be used for point-in-time restores or geo-restores. And long-term backups are backups that can be configured for up to 10 years for keeping backup data. And in most cases, they are used for compliance reasons because different industries are having these different regulations.
Got it. Okay, so there are quite a few different options that we can choose depending on our compliance, our regulations, whatever our specifications are. Now, when we talk about storing these backups, how is the backup data stored?
So in Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL Manager Instance, excluding the hyperscale service tier, backup data is kept on storage accounts that are separate from the storage accounts keeping original data. And furthermore, these storage accounts are replicated to another redundant storage. So far, the redundancy used is geo-redundancy, which means that storage account is replicated to the geo-paired region.
Got it. So typically, we're using geo-redundant storage for basically all deployments where, you know, you might be deployed to East US, and then the backup would also be in a paired region, which would be like West US. Now, are there other options that are available or new options, I think?
Yeah, as you can probably see on the slide, recently, we have introduced a couple of additional options for the backup storage redundancy. And besides the default geo-redundant backup storage, which already mentioned replicates the backup data to the geo-paired region, there is zone-redundant backup storage option that replicates backups across different availability zones in the same regions. And also, there is locally redundant backup storage that replicates data inside the same data center. While geo and locally redundant backup storage options are available in all regions, zone redundant backup storage is specific to the regions that support availability zones, and their storage supports also zone replication.
Got it. Okay, so there's a few different options here. How do I go about choosing like which option is going to be right for me?
Yeah, that is a good and important question. And on this slide, we can see a couple of comparisons. When customers are choosing between redundancy, there are two aspects to consider. One is definitely data residency, because different industries and different business requirements have different regulations. If your business is having a requirement to keep the data in the same region, then zone and local redundancy are the best fit for you, because in this case, data is replicated in the same region across availability zones or inside the same data center when local redundancy is chosen. With these two options in place, geo-restore capability is not possible, as it is specific to the backup data that is replicated to another region. So with geo-redundancy, customers are getting a cost-effective solution for disaster recovery. From the other hand, pricing is also one of the inputs when deciding on backup storage redundancy, because it goes lower starting from geo to the local redundancy. And this is good opportunity for cost savings and for reducing backup costs. And this can be applied in some environments where data durability is not so important. For example, dev test environments, Q&A environments, and if there is some other disaster recovery technique besides GeoRestore.
Got it. Okay, so this has been really useful. I actually really like that chart, so I can kind of compare what I'm getting versus what I'm not getting, and then kind of see how price and durability are going to play into that. Thanks so much for explaining that, all this to us today. We are going to put some links in the description so people can learn more about kind of what to use when and maybe dive deeper into some of these options. Thanks again for joining us today. And for our viewers, thanks for joining. If you like this video, please like this video, leave us a comment, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.